Hello everybody and welcome back to part two, another video. I'm Alex Antuna and this is jumping back into Nomad Sculpt on my tablet. Now part one was put out a few days ago and this is part two of me just kind of continuing on. You can see I have a little bit of PBR material, just going back and forth, just putting some details and some final touches. Kind of wanted to keep it a little bit more clay, as I mentioned in the last video, a little more claymation. There's a little bit more folds that I'm trying to get in, a little more clothing detail, remeshing. I think at this point I'm kind of getting the hang of it, working on the model, pushing and pulling. And from the last video, like I said, it's very similar to ZBrush, so it's not unfamiliar territory, it's just learning where all the tools are. Starting to add some, what is it, buttons? I think I'm going to add some buttons here. Just kind of scale, use your scale, transform, push and pull. Pretty fun program. I love it. You know, I can't complain. this program, it's worth getting. If you're into 3D or just interested in just learning some basics of 3D or anything, this program can't hurt you. Everything in here are basic fundamentals of going from any other program of 3D Max to Blender. It's just different location of the tools. Most of this is more like sculpting though, not hard surface, but you can still get a pretty decent amount of detail and then remesh it if you wanted a concept with that. So you can see the little concept on the top left. Still kind of there, just kind of using that for a little bit of a reference. Getting a remeshing. Remeshing the model, getting a little more detail. Pretty cool. Once you get a good understanding of remeshing, it kind of makes it things easier, just kind of to block things out, to kind of get like actual just shapes and forms. And then once you learn that you can combine those models, makes things a little easier. Didn't really know what I wanted this to be, just kind of like a little bit of pants and going back and forth. Sculpting and sculpting. That crease is real good for like getting a little more harder to find details. It reminds me of the damn standard from ZBrush, but it could use a little bit more adjustments to get just right, but it works for what it is. Redoing the nose, just trying to get this back in there. You can mask and you can extract just like ZBrush. Boom. Now you got a mesh. You can adjust it, get it just right, and then you're going forward. Then you got it. There's a lot of neat things in this program. Inflation, remeshing, just trying to get a look. There it is. You got a little nose. That's cool right there. You have all those little PBR materials. I saw today in Twitter, or X, however you want to call it. Everybody knows about Twitter. But somebody posted a pretty cool detailed like a potion jewelry looking thing. And I don't know. It's just so cool that you can do that in this program. The reflections and the metallic and then the the liquid and the glass refractions and stuff. It looked pretty cool. Gotta ignore the lawnmower in the background. It's a little ambient noise back there, or loud noise. Just more detail, just depending on like when you start modeling and stuff, you'll find where you want to be. Just add more. That's a bigger pocket, so I just kind of went back and started adding more details. I think I even painted some like fake ambient occlusion kind of dirt in there, give a little dirtiness to it. And this is cool. Like, I guess I'll say this is like one of the first times actually painting inside of Nomad, and I was really happy with it. It took a little bit to find where everything was, but once I found all the stuff, I was like, oh, you got roughness and colors and you can adjust, go back and forth. I was just like, oh, this is so cool. Like, man, it's almost too good to be true, but it works. It's really cool. You can kind of define your character, your look a little better. Went with the blue, a little more blue. You got little buttons. I could probably make those a little shinier, but I don't think I did. Painting in some variation of color, just kind of give them a little bit more adjustments there. What it'll do is adjust the whole mesh when you change the color, so you can kind of see how it looks. Whenever you get near, on most projects, like near the end, it's like, oh man, it's good to see the finish line, and knowing that you're, even though it's fun, it's always good to know that you're almost close to being, you know, that much closer to being finished. It's always a good payoff. His eyes are still kind of creepy. I give him a little dots for eyes, kind of like clay, going from there. A little more wrinkles, right? You gotta have more wrinkles. I was debating about giving him that cap, the his hoodie, but I'll go ahead and put it in near the end. Check this out. This is cool. You've got on that little window, it was bloom, ambient occlusion. It's a lot of little parameters you can adjust to make your rendering look finalized. And that's so cool. Here's his little eyes. It's cool because you can use the symmetry so you can kind of get a real quick look. It looks like he's crazy. Got the crazy eyes. Painting his ears a little bit more detail. What's gonna do here? I don't know. Oh, ground. Yeah, just getting the ground. Always helps. It's a matte cap. And see right here, you got your environments. You can find the right one, rotate it around to get the right look. Again, this is all on my tablet. It's a very powerful program. Oh, there's my other older models practice learning. Look at that. That's pretty cool. It's like, looks like the rendering in here is pretty powerful. Playing with the colors a little bit, a little color grading. There's so much. Little vignette, sharpness. You can even make it like pixel art. It's yeah, really cool. He's getting there, pretty close to the end, right? Didn't know where his eyes needed to be. I'm just kind of playing around. I didn't really want him to have button eyes. That's kind of creepy. Although it would have been cool too, but I feel like you always think of the Coraline movie, so didn't want to go that route. It's already been taken, that style. Oh, check that out. Did you see me? I can move. You can adjust that little window easily. You can just hold your pin down or whatever, and it'll move those little brushes around. So you can actually, it's real user friendly. If you need a tool to be more up top, just drag it to the top. That's really where it's at. Another extract, trying to get his little lip. Kind of came out weird, but just kind of playing with it till you get it right. Sculpting it. Push and pull. Wrong button. There you go. Just small detail. Even that gizmo's the pivot. You can adjust that too. There you go. He's got like a little tongue or lip or something. There's like a little window of different presets. There you go. If I really wanted to, I could export this model and then kind of like remesh it and then put it into something like Tool Bag or Substance Painter and get even more details and textures onto them. Who knows, maybe I'll try it, maybe I don't. We'll see. For now, I'm calling this done. It was just a good little practice, but I've been trying to go back to older models to see what I got to kind of play around with. Check this out. That, even that's like a spline kind of masking. There's different ways to do it. Trying to get an idea with his hands, trying to make a little glove, his little mittens, because it's cold wherever he's going. Thinking about it now, I could have added like some like rocks and some ground and gone a little bit further with it. Really, really depends on how far you want to push it, right? I didn't really feel any slowdown on my tablet, and whatever this model is, it worked pretty good. It didn't even struggle. I've tried to up the resolution, and there's been a few times where on other models that I was testing, it can get slow if you kind of trying to subdivide too many parts. But if you're smart about it and remesh and keep your models pretty smart, you can get a lot in these little scenes. See, there's a decimation, there's voxel, and for anybody new, like decimation is kind of like a transitioning to like a lower res, but keeping the res. The voxel just kind of, it's like your Dynamesh, and the other one's like Z remesher, right? Kind of, I don't know. But there's options. That's the good thing. It's crazy talk right now, right? And they update this program pretty often. Anytime I've seen an update, it's just been like, oh wow, that's cool. haven't really been holding back too much on it. Like, there was something with their tubes with more detail, and I just, you know, it's so much stuff. There's like arrays in here. There's a lot of power in this little program. And it's not so much little anymore. It's actually kind of, I consider this pretty pretty worthy of using to get some kind of ideas out, or even get models to start with, or even models to get your base. Look at that, he got the mask, went all the way through. It was just the mask in the back of his head. His head's a little weird, but it's okay. We're gonna put a hood on it. Gotta cover him up. There we go. Extract, and then there you go. You got another mesh. Just need to put a color on it, and that's it. I think I had a little trouble with the remeshing on the edges, but for what it was just, it's fine. It was all right. What was that? Symmetry on there. So we can use it. Inflate, wrong brush, right? Just want to inflate that edge. Then remesh. It's pretty neat. But hopefully in this video there was some, you know, something to use. I know it was kind of sped up, and I watch sped up videos too. You know, I like watching just about anything that's kind of informative. Sometimes you'll catch something, you're like, man, I didn't know you could do that. And it just takes a few seconds, you'll catch it, and you'll be like, dang, okay. Even the little layout, it's pretty customizable. You can customize a lot of it to be a little bit more user friendly. You can flip the layout to be left or right, up or down. Some of the UI, I think you can shrink it to have so many panels or icons per panel. See that there's a quality in that render area too. I do notice like the tablet will get a little hot, but as long as you're in a cooled environment, like you're not out in the sun doing this, you should be okay. But it does put a little heat on that little brain in the tablet that I have working overtime. But these little tablets nowadays, they're so powerful just for what they are. Trying to get a color for his head. There you go. He's got a little raincoat kind of hoodie. Something to cover his head. Kind of playing with the brushes, getting a little more, cleaning it up. But the next model, when I get around to it, I want to use the keyboard to try to see if that helps the workflow to go a little bit quicker. Because using my fingers to go back and forth, the smooth and stuff like that, it's cool to have if you don't have a keyboard. But if you have a keyboard, then why not use it? Then you just get a little travel keyboard that folds out. I got a pretty neat one that I like, but you just need a little button to toggle, and that's it. We'll be traveling next week with my wife, so we're gonna take our tablets and stuff with us, and so hopefully on the waits between the flights and stuff, I'll probably get some modeling done and get something kind of created while on the go. Because nothing, you know, like, it's always fun, you know, whenever you're just kind of waiting and you can do something productive. I always feel like creating is kind of productive. You learn something, do something, make a cool little model. So I need to remesh that right there. You see the little jagged? Remesh it and get it right. There it is. Boom. Subdivide. It didn't help. It needed to be remeshed or dynameshed or something. I'm going to get some of those rough edges smooth back. But it's all good. He's got a lost look, his eyes. He's just like at the 1,000-yard stare. He does need to be posed. He needs a little pose to him. But for what this was, it was a good little learning go. There you are. Got the little details in there. Still trying to clean up that hood, I think, right there. See? Got a little cleaner. It was like most models, you can always just keep refining. But it's about the end of this video. This is pretty much the whole model. And hopefully it was informative. Hopefully everybody's doing well out there. And, you know, appreciate y'all watching. So I'll see y'all in the next video. Later.